Hi there. So now we will dive into Universal Audio Luna and see what kind of drum sequencers we can use with Luna with external drum machines like TR-8S. So say goodbye to the boring beats and let's get going with Luna. So in Luna, you don't actually have any sequencer. The only MIDI effect that you have in Luna is the arp and arpeggio, and you can pretty much use that one to kind of do arpeggios, but it isn't a drum sequencer. One way to trick it, and that's only if you have, for example, a Reason. Reason can be added as a Reason rack plugin. So I can add a Reason over here, and then I can go into the browser, and I'm not selecting any of the instruments, but I just go into the browser. And I go into the players and I go into the drum sequencer in Reason and I'll take that into use. So now basically when I have Reason over here and I have the drum sequencer in Reason, you can basically of course program the Reason drum sequencer to reflect the right notes in your external drum machine. In this case, It's basically the TR-8S, and now this plugin will send MIDI out into the channel 1. I wonder if it is routing it to the then from there to kind of channel 10 that I have in my TR-8S. Anyway, I have created these templates for Reason Rack plugin, and I have a video coming up where I show in Reason how to configure this Reason Rack plugin within Reason. So I will basically show that over there. Here I just state that Luna doesn't have any sequencer. You could use any sequencer like MIDI sequencers that work as a MIDI effects. In this case, I'm basically using the Reason as an example. An example of like external sequencer used with Luna to command external drum machine like TR-8X or equivalent. So I go into music and I go into my region and I go into my, I think it's in the presets. Yeah, it's here. So now when I load this one, okay, it double loaded it. So let's delete this one. Okay, cut device. So now I have here the TR-8S, how I have programmed it with this one. And in Reason, in this case, it kind of brings you the pattern as well that has been programmed. But you can always start with the new pattern and then you kind of hear nothing. So now if I press play, nothing will play, but then when I start to program here into Reason, and then now what it does is basically I use the Reason Rack plugin and the player, the drum player over there, the sequencer to do the sequencing, and then it will send the MIDI into the TR-8S. TR-8S will play it and the audio gets routed back into Luna. And that's basically the only way currently you can do it in Luna. So you need to have some external third-party sequencer that you use to sequence your drums. But for example, if you happen to have a Reason, Reason works great with Luna in this case, so you can then easily kind of do drum programming with Reason. So let's do like a simple pattern here. And then let's play it. But then now you would really need to do all the sequencing in here. So it's not the best, but it kind of works, and it's usable. But now once you're doing it like this, you can't actually take this MIDI and transfer that into the Luna. So you actually need to use the sequencer, and it's not that convenient, but it kind of works. And this is just an example of using external sequencer with Luna when Luna doesn't have one. So that's what Luna offers today. Other than that, Luna is a great digital audio workstations for recording and mixing and mastering. But as it is in a very early state, it doesn't have all the tools and kind of bells and whistles as other digital audio workstations have. But it does have a great audio and audio engine and the certain plugins like Neve summing and so on and so forth. But this is the one where Luna doesn't shine that bright. But anyway, you can use an external drum sequencer with Luna and get going in this way. So that's about it. And by the way, you can then of course record this. So I'll just move the sequencer away. And if I now run it, I could then, if I put recording on these channels, I could record all these audios. So I can play the sequence and record it here in Luna. And then of course I can use audio after that. So that's one way to play around with this. So So now if I go and disable this one, so I basically disable it, and then I do a loop of 8 bars here. Now I need to take of course the monitoring off and all that stuff, so I just hear the audio. But anyway, you get the point regarding on this. So This is the workaround, so that if you want to play around with the sequencer in Reason, then record it here, or any external sequencer and record it here, and then you know you can do different patterns and record them as audio and then use the audio from there on. So that was Universal Audio Luna. Next we will dive into Cubase 13 Pro. Remember to subscribe for the channel for more content. Thanks for watching. Bye now.